I know I'm a spitting image of him. I know, looking at the amount of people here, there's an awesome task ahead of me. About 2 days before Daddy left, or the night before he left, we spoke. Normally I would go into his room and lock the door and we just have our alone time, you know, as much as I could get. And the last time we spoke, I went into his room, lying beside him, and he took my hand, I was looking at it. And he said to me, Marlon, how do you know when you have a connection with Jesus? And I said to him, well, and I stopped, and something just told me that I need to use my cell phone to record his voice, because I don't know if I'll ever hear it again. I took my cell phone out, he didn't even know that I started recording it. So I said to him, well, you know, when you talk to God, like how I'm talking to you right now, that's how you know when you have a relationship with him. And he said, yes, son, but you have to read your Bible constantly. And we spoke for about 5 minutes. Then he said to me, you know, he was tired, he needed to have some rest, because he needed to wake up the next morning to, you know, do a little exercise and leave out. I left the room that night and I went to my room and I started counting all the blessings I had. It was the first time I've ever held my father's hand, first time I walked with him, the first time we had a heart-to-heart talk where there was nothing in between us. There was us. This connection. I couldn't leave. I wanted to go to up there and I just couldn't leave. I just had to be by his side. And I just want to thank God for giving me the chance to be able to speak to him, to get all those years that I may have missed, you know? And when I look at this coming year, I don't see my father. I don't see him. All I see is a body, and this is just the official program. But he left a long time ago. But there's one thing that sticks with me. My father never tried to be the most powerful man. He never... This man was so humble. It's hard to even explain. And to see where he was able to touch so many hearts, that people were able to, just by coming in contact with him, you recognize the person that he is. And it brought one thing home to me. And it was the last thing he said to me. Have a connection with God and everything else will work itself out. He never asked me to take care of the family. He never asked me to go do anything else. The last thing he said to me, gain a connection with Jesus Christ and everything else will work itself out. So we're going to do this song together and I hope you guys enjoy.
Before we sing, I just want to say briefly, that my friend and I went to many funerals before together. He would have been right there. But he would want me to see him. And so today, I encourage all of you. God is going to sing for us today.
Yes.
And to his name.
The glory.
God the praise, because God is still God.
As we watch. watched as his life ebbed away.
His body and sealed up the grave.